I'll be around.
And basically, every single chain ends with a great lord. Well, at least.
Bearer of the curse. Seek, lest this.
I don't think I know. But yeah. What I will be going up in right now is actually vitality. Well, it's not vitality in this game, that's in the first game. Here it's called vigor, which actually makes more sense, but... And you see, if we walk over here, now we have this guy sitting right here, which will allow us to gain access to this area down here without having to buy the ring. Now we will need
the name.
All right, I have.
We can tell him to set up a ladder.
Fine. Sure.
You need a ladder, but you'll.
And depending on how much we give him, I'm guessing the ladder will be longer or shorter. So if we just give him 500 souls, as we can afford right now, the ladder will be short, and we will only be able to go like part of the way before dropping down, and the fall will most likely kill us.
Oi.
If I'm not mistaken. Or maybe not. Hold on.
What?
Well, you just...
Fine then.
I will just be looking at this to see if my hypothesis is correct, because paying 500 souls to this guy will probably cause him to put down a small ladder, which will only reach down to the... Okay, so my hypothesis is slightly wrong.
This ladder, don't it? Cheers for that.
Okay, so my hypothesis is wrong.
Well.
Okay.
Oi.
I thought that maybe, basically what I thought, was that maybe the different prices of ladders would allow him to set up a ladder that went further down. So if we paid him 500, it would make that ladder go all the way down to that one platform there, the one with the item on that you see right there. But if we paid him 3,500, it would maybe go down to the further platform there with an item on. But if we pay him 12,000, it'll go down all the way to the door that we need to go through. That was what I thought. Apparently he's a cheap ass and will only accept souls. Well, he will only give you a ladder that goes that far. Which is really a little bit cheap if you ask me, but never mind that. I guess we'll just have to save up like 12,000 souls and buy a large ladder. And yes, you could just jump down there with the cat ring, but I don't like buying a cat ring, because I won't be using it other than just that one single spot. Okay, we'll just have to look at my equipment ever so slightly. So we did receive the Ring of Thorns from Pig, which I will not be using, because that ring is absolute bullcrap. In my opinion, it's not only because it's a little bit cheap, but it's also because of the damage power that it actually has is not that much of a big deal. Okay. Note to self, don't trigger both of them at the same time. At least try to not. Trigger both of them at the same time. Yeah. But We've now reached one of the areas that I really like because you can get a katana. I really do enjoy the katana. Guys, is they break my poise immediately. So basically, if I start tagging them and they manage to hit me before I break their poise, I will, my attack chain will end and I'll have to restart it in order to kill them. And that's actually a weakness about the Twin Blade. I think the Twin Blade is better suited for people with poise. Which is why I will just for a second try and equip some of this equipment. It will make me fast roll, but wow, it's actually bringing my load up to more than 100%. It's actually pretty insane. And he still breaks my poise. That's crazy. I'm literally wearing... That's bullshit! That is absolute bullshit and you know it. I'm literally wearing the most amount of poise that I have available. Of course, that I only have available at the moment, which isn't exactly saying I have a lot of poise. But I basically have... It's basically one of the highest amounts of poise that I can get right now. And they're just ripping through it, like nothing. So that doesn't work at all. Hey. What? Okay. So I am thinking that this weapon is not really suited for this area, which is where this weapon comes in. Now, this will mean that I will be having a lot of weight. I will be heavily overweight,
but it should also mean that I should be capable of killing these guys. It's really annoying actually that I can't. Even though it's unupgraded, I'm still dealing a lot of damage. I am fat rolling, which means that I will actually be changing to this setup. Now this is very, very overweight. I am currently at 116%
what?
Maximum weight. It's not ideal, really. What I will buy is buy those. Oh, I won't buy those. I will buy that one, though.
Cheers.
Because I will just be equipping
Jester's gloves. And the reason for this. Okay. Is there anything that has better fire resistance? Yes. The black rose, which I can't really wield effectively. Basically everything has better fire resistance right here. But I will be using. Ooh, the dark leggings. When did I get those? Wonder when I got the dark leggings. What I will be doing first though is I will just go down here and see if I can trigger this guy to come at me. Now the annoying thing about these guys is that they will actually give you death if you're not careful. Which is why I like having such high damage output weapon. Because that basically means I can just help them and they will just die. I rolled in the water. Fucking bullshit. I don't get why they sometimes just kill you off, even though you're doing what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to roll in that water to get that item. And they just don't care. They're just like, nope, you're not allowed in this room. And they just kill you off. You legitimately do exactly what you're supposed to be doing. And it's not good enough. What's up with that? Can someone please explain that to me? Because that is bullshit. Actually, let's have a look at the pursuers. It actually doesn't have that bad stats. I mean, I'm concerning myself right now with the amount of blocking that it can do. I will actually just try it out. That might actually work out. Because I'll also be able to two-shot them, which means I don't have to worry about myself running out of stamina all of a sudden. Oh god, oh god, oh god. You fucking god, you bitch! Now I will be luring this guy out here. Because of the fact that I know there is an archer located right up here. It's not an archer I wish to deal with. Especially not if he's going to be shooting me while I'm trying to fight the other guys. I'm not a big fan of that. Not at all. I remember the very first time I passed through this door, I just saw that crossbow and I was like, oh shit. I legitimately thought it was just gonna shoot me. That didn't really lead anywhere. I mean, it did give me 20 fire arrows, which is always good. I will just be triggering this guy and drawing him back. Because, as you just saw there, there's another archer on the top of that specific hill. And I do not like dealing with archers, especially not these Alun archers. Okay. go. Nice. In a nice location. We take you down. Now I will also just plop down here. I know that there's an item here that I would very much like. And I think going over here. No? Okay. So that does not trigger that guy. Which is a good thing actually. But we need this ladder in order to get up here. Take down this bad boy. Uh-oh. I know that broke my voice, but I'll just push him off. And that's that. Now the reason why I have equipped the Jester's Gloves, I didn't tell you this, but the reason why I've equipped the Jester's Gloves is because equipping those increases the amount of souls that you get. And I really do love souls in this game. Especially because they're basically used for everything. Just about everything. Actually not dealing that much damage, but it still takes a bit of a chunk off my health. Now one thing I will do here is I'll wait for that guy to shoot his arrow, and then I'll trigger this guy and then run back, because that guy will just back off. He will legitimately just run off the edge, and I don't know why he's such an idiot, but he is, and it's not exactly, I don't exactly disapprove of it. That guy was just about doing the same thing. There we go. Takes care of that guy. Now, I don't really like this area particularly much. And the reason for this is because you need to get the doll ember from this platform. Now I've tried jumping that platform a lot of times actually. Ow, how the fuck do you hit me? Jesus Christ, let me finish talking, you douche. Anyways, the doll ember is right there on that platform, on that staircase. The only way to get to it is by either getting up there, which is, well, impossible, unless you get it from the actual platform itself, or by jumping off right here. Now, I failed this jump so many times. I don't even want to admit it, but so many times I just failed this jump. But here goes. I cannot even explain to you how many times I died on that one jump. I mean, it's basically not even funny. No? There we go. Jesus Christ, I almost fell off. Now that I have 3 ferrous lock stones. Because this water is healing, I will actually use this. and then turn human, because there's an NPC here that I would prefer having on my team. See, bam, I healed up. So this water is healing, which is amazing. Now, I'm still fat rolling a little bit, so I will probably change this weapon to something else, like the Drang Lake. The damage isn't quite as good, but it's enough to make do. And my shield, see, 100% physical and fire. Fire and physical are the two main types of damage that we need to worry about here. Which means I'll be using the tower shield. Which, oh dear god. Boss, so you don't really need to take care of it. You can, but you don't need to. I like doing it, but only because I really, really like his weapon, and I really like the boss battle itself. Alright, and now... there is something else that we need to take care of. And this is something that most of you might know. I'm not sure how many of you actually know this. But if you go back to the smelter students room, this will happen. Basically, the shooter will be spotted. Though he's grown up, so he's not that big a deal. Although I would prefer using that attack right here, because that is really easy to avoid. Just rolling once to the side, or towards him rather, and it's avoided. Unlike that one right here, that one is kind of hard to avoid, as it's a 3-hit combo. And that one right there is absolutely necessary to avoid. Not even blocking it or doing anything. I mean, it does appear to be magical when you see it, but I don't know if it is, but it will curse you if he hits you with it, and it's actually a grab attack. It's kind of a grab. So yeah, he stabs his sword into you, and even if you're blocking, he'll still hit you and deal a relative amount of damage to you. Oh, Jesus. Okay. That did not deal as much damage as I thought it would. Which is a good thing. Very good thing. We have almost done it, which is a good thing. I like how easy this boss battle appears to be right now, because we have grown up so much and gotten so much great equipment. Okay. I will just try and see if I can trigger this. This gives me a chance to heal, and it triggers this. Oh. Whoa, what is that? I've never seen that effect before. Okay. That's a bit scary. But yeah. Now we have the Ring of Blades plus one. Right now we're getting 165 boost out of this just regular damage buff. Now we're getting 180. So it's basically added 15 extra points of physical damage to our attacks, which is awesome. Now I will most likely have to go with a sword for this one. Not a shield in the main slot. This and this one. I will just travel back to Majula though to level up, because I would prefer not losing the souls that I have right now. And then I'm going to try and see if we can get to the
bearer lest this
to the last to the old Iron King, the last boss in the area. Now I will continue Goblin vigor a little bit, so I can take a couple of hits. Shit, I forgot about the ladder. Well, never mind. After we defeat the old Iron King, we'll just use that ladder. And this is the second location at which you can spawn in. Well, no. This is the second location at which you can actually join the Bellkeeper Covenant, if you want to do that. So I don't want to do that, because I think that covenant is full of shit. Not to be a douche or anything, but I think it is full of shit. Nah, mate. Okay, now, look at the setup right here, right? This is really not an ideal setup because there is a... Why do I have poison arrows? Oh well. There are two of those guys over there. Two of those turtle things. Now the first one is not a problem. He will go at you and the other one will just stay where he is. However, the other one will, in the meantime, the other one will bash away at the floor, causing the floor to collapse. Not the whole floor, it's just like a square, like one of these squares will just disappear and you'll just be able to jump over it, but I don't really like doing that. And also I don't really like fighting these guys out here, in there, because I'm really, really bad at that location. That specific location is a nightmare for me, basically. Because I keep rolling off the side for some reason. Now we can take out our shield again, and hopefully we can lower this guy, or he'll warp off himself, and then we can lower these two turtles into the lava, killing them, and then we can pull it up again. Now the thing to notice about this area is there are these kind of... The thing to notice about this area is there are these kind of platforms, right? But some of them will fall down occasionally. Now, as far as I've been able to learn, it is completely random which of them actually fall down. And if there even is any of them that's going to fall down. But you can tell which of them is going to fall down by going up to them. You see, that one just fell down. And it only fell down after I passed it. I don't know what the... Okay, then. Now he was not, I was not expecting him to trigger and go over to me. I was expecting him to just stay over there. I don't know why I was expecting him to just stay idly by while I was over here. But I was expecting him to be standing over there. So it was pretty lucky that I managed to see him before he got over to me. But yeah, I mean, sometimes these kind of things will just randomly, fall down. And the way that works is basically you can hear them when they're about to fall down, basically. You can kind of hear if they're about to fall down. Which can give you a pointer on which ones are actually going to fall down. Okay, not need to do that. Well, he's just going to spray back and forth. I might as well just take him down. But you can kind of hear it. There's like a rattling noise when it's about to fall down. So you can kind of hear it. Yeah. I really love the Dragon Lake sword in this one, honestly. Now, there's actually a trick to this guy. because there isn't a right over here, which I will just trigger right over here, and then have a stand right there because exactly. I didn't expect you to fall down that early, but I don't know if it's meant to be a trap for you, or if it's meant to be an easy way to kill those guys. I don't know which one of them is, but I do know that it kills them instantly. So as soon as you see that area, just go straight for that. Just go open that up, go over and trigger him, and then run back to that one, because, and then just keep him standing there all the while, because he will just be standing there, and be, his ass will be handed to him by that thing if he stands there for too long. And as long as you can just keep him there, he'll basically just die. Also, one thing that I am actually wondering about in the in this area is actually because there are occasionally you can hear a bell toll. I think it is a bell toll. Yeah, you can hear that occasionally in this area, and I'm not sure what that means, but I'm assuming it means that some player have deactivated, well, not deactivated, but that some player have rung the bell in the bell tower in some other world, I am assuming. I'm not sure that's the case, but if it is, it is fucking cool, I will say. I think it is amazingly cool if that's the case. If the players if the world legitimately hangs so much together, so if one player rings the bell, and all the other players in this area at that time will actually be able to hear the bell. I think that'd be really cool if that's the case. Right now, guy that we are actually going to fight will be slightly tough. The reason for this is because he is the last boss in this area. But the reason why it's so tough is because basically he has in his area, in his boss location, there are small holes which will lead into this lava, which sucks. But also, he's using some really annoying attacks. And even if I did have a shield with a decent fire defense, he would just tear right through that shield and right through my stamina. I mean, he wouldn't tear through the shield. It would be able to block him if it had decent fire block. But it would tear through my stamina instantly. And I would just fall, be shot into the lava, most likely. And this is him. I'm not sure I'm supposed to do him alone. He just keeps using the fire breath. long as he's using that. You'll just be able to sidestep and you'll walk backstep. And then there'll be a problem. Oh dear lord. That's also a problem. So he uses the swipe attack first. And then still need to be wary because, as you can see to my right, there is in fact a wolf goblin, which is like second, third. Because, in my opinion, it seems to be easier to beat him if you are alone. As long as you can get down his moveset and actually... If you can get down his moveset and figure out how to dodge his attacks, you will be able to just go around and like dodge his attacks and then attack him when he uses the attacks that allows him that leaves him open basically. Which is why I really think it's important that you just stay the hell away from him. Honestly. Well there was something I need. Oh yeah. I needed to buy the large ladder. 12,000 souls.
Well,
no.
There
we go.
Well, really? I guess.
Here we go. I really liked this guy in the beginning, but I don't really like him now, to be honest.
Not to be a douchebag or anything, but I really think it's a bit of a douche. Now you can see the ladder goes basically all the way down.
The only things I sell are...
And you can see, he has actually set up a different ladder. Which doesn't... Whoa! That actually does go all the way down. Okay, fuck that. I'm buying second ladder from you too, as well.
Well...
Oh yes, I am indeed. Because I'm thinking that is actually going to cause... See. Now this ladder will lead us to this place. And this ladder will lead us to this place. But I will just go over and see if I might be able to level up my weapons. And then I will see. I will actually see which kind of things she sells now. Because, yes, as you can see, the Titanite shards has now gone. She now has unlimited Titanite shards. And she's also opened up to selling large Titanite shards. Which is very good. I don't really know if I want to buy them all, though.
No,
really. No. I will just be seeing if I can upgrade any of my equipment. Yes. Now, let's have a look here. The Drang Lake Sword, that was the one I wanted to upgrade. I will be saving up for the next one. For the next Twinkling Titanite. So I can, because the Drang Lake Sword is just, it's just so good.
I'll be around.
And the rest of the souls, I guess we'll be using on leveling up at this point.
Yours, I only.
And once again, I will be pumping everything into vigor. Because I really need some more health. I really need to be able to take a punch. Now I will be equipping the Dragon Sword for the next couple of times because the Dragon Sword is amazing. But yeah, that was the Old Iron King and the Smelting. Wow, we've done a lot of things in this session. Jesus Christ. I will be shortening it, so you'll see it over a couple of episodes. But in this session, we've defeated the Covetous Demon. We have defeated Mitha, the Baneful Queen. We've defeated the Smelter Demon. We've defeated the Old Iron King, another Great Lord. And we've set up a ladder so we can go down there next time, which is awesome. Alright, did we actually defeat any other? No, that was the ones. We defeated these four souls that we've gained. Was the ones we defeated today. That's good. That's really good. Wow. I like this. One thing that I will do, however, before finishing, is just burn this sublime bone dust. Because I think it is a brilliant way to end an episode with a strengthening of the Estus Flask. And there we go. 5 Estus Flasks plus 2. But as always, see you next time, guys. Bye.